Now, for more on this and a man who knows what's going on there on the ground in the Granite State, even though he lives in Massachusetts, is Howie Carr. Howie, great to have you back with us.
Hey, thanks, John. I appreciate it. I think that the Libertarians are going to be less of a factor this year than they were in 2012. As you know, they knocked off probably, I think, six or seven Republican congressmen who would have been Republican congressmen otherwise. There was one in Massachusetts, a guy named John Tierney, a Democrat, one of the most corrupt Democrats in Congress. His wife went to prison for laundering $8 million in cash for her gangster brothers. And he should have lost by all rights, but a Libertarian took 16,000 votes away. Mia Love out in Utah, I mean, she's going to be elected this time, but she lost by 700 votes, and a Libertarian took 6,300 votes away. I think people have wakened up, and they realize that there's a big problem in the country, and it's not the time for a protest vote. I know in Tierney's district, there's the Libertarian has been convinced to step aside, and I ultimately don't see the Libertarian in New Hampshire as making a difference in the election.
All right, let's take a look at the poll numbers, though, on that race. Now, according to some polls, and we have them up here on the screen if we can get to them, Scott Brown does trail Shaheen by 10 percentage points with Gardner Goldsmith. I'm sorry, this is the wrong. That was the wrong poll. That was the poll of, you know, folks favoring Mitt Romney. But let's talk a little bit more about the independent candidate there, because he is pulling away just a couple percentage points. Who is that affecting the most, Shaheen or Scott Brown?
Well, obviously it's affecting Scott Brown. I mean, you're not gonna make a decision to go with, well, I'm either gonna go with no government or Obama style government. It's going to affect Scott Brown. But I think as time goes on, I think people have, or at least some people have realized that this is a penny wise, pound foolish to be throwing your vote away on somebody who hasn't got a chance. I just can't see it. I mean, Scott Brown came up with a pretty good ad last week. He was the first Republican Senate candidate to try to tie his incumbent Democrat opponent, Gene Shaheen, to the mess down on the southern border. And it was a pretty effective ad. I mean, just very calm, Scott Brown talking and saying she votes with him all the time. You know, another thing about Jean Shaheen is that she's one of the people who signed the letter that Carl Levin wrote back in, I think, 2011, the senator from Michigan, demanding that the IRS target Tea Party groups. And again, I mean, if the Libertarians are really concerned about government overreach, I mean, this is a classic example. And Scott Brown is hitting this everywhere he goes. When you talk about the Free State crowd in New Hampshire, the Libertarians, the second right crowd, the people who don't like Dodd-Frank, I mean, that's what they hold against Scott Brown to a greater or lesser degree. Mm-hmm. They can't take this kind of IRS scrutiny. I mean, to a certain group, this is as important, if not more so, of important than the immigration disaster.
Well, Howie, we got a look on Friday of how Gene Shaheen is trying to walk that line. And, you know, while most of the country on Friday afternoon was talking about the failures of the GOP-controlled House of Representatives to pass an emergency immigration bill, one that the Speaker himself supported, the incumbent Senator, Jean Shaheen from New Hampshire, was at a VFW talking about, in her words, the historic expansion of VA health care for vets, along with GOP Senator Kelly Ayotte, you know, who wasn't there, of course. That was Scott Brown. A pretty savvy piece of Twitter craft, if you will, by Senator Shaheen. You have to begrudgingly give her that.
Yeah, no, you know, look, she's been elected the governor, I think, three times up there. They have 2-year terms, and so she's run twice statewide for the Senate. So, I mean, this is what, her sixth time maybe running statewide in New Hampshire. She knows how to play the game, no question about it. It's just I don't know. I'm not saying that Scott Brown is in the lead, but I just think he's got a legitimate chance, especially if he can wrap himself around Mitt Romney, who's extremely, extremely popular in New Hampshire right now. You've seen the polls, John. I think he would get, according to some of the polls, he would get 39% of the vote in a multi-candidate GOP presidential primary. I mean, that's huge. That's huge. There's major buyer's remorse. I think there is everywhere, but especially in New Hampshire, about voting for Obama.
How Howie, I want to switch gears here for a minute, Miranda here. Changing gears to Mitt Romney. He has kind of reemerged as one of the top Republican Party picks for the 2016 presidential election.
Yes.
What do you think? Do you think he has a good chance? Is it his charm? Like, why all of a sudden are voters wanting him back in?
You know, I watched the documentary Mitt that was put out by Netflix, which I'd recommend everybody see it if they haven't already. And at the end of that, I thought, wow, that's the end for Mitt. You know, it's really a bittersweet conclusion to the film. And he seems really brokenhearted, and talking about how the country's going downhill. But you know, now he seems to be totally over that. And in part, I think because of how positively the documentary Mitt made him look among the politically inclined people, Republicans especially. I think he's back in it. I really do. I mean, I don't think
do you?
He would be. I never thought he was. I never thought he was back in it. I thought that this.
I think you and most people.
They were kidding themselves.
Right. What about Dr. Carson? We just had him on the show earlier today. Do you think there's a chance that he could run? He would only give us a maybe answer, or should I say, a John Reform? He actually said, "I'll give you a yes and a no." I took that as a maybe.
Anytime someone says they're being urged to run, I feel like they're probably going to run. I mean, he's definitely going to run. I always wonder though how someone's going to do in their first campaign. You know, whether it's for state rep or for president of the United States, it's a hard thing to do the first time out. You know, there's a lot of. A lot of kinks you have to get out of your system, and I'm not sure that he's really ready for prime time. I mean, I really like the guy, and he's quite articulate, and he's
all right. Well, Howie, we'll have to leave it there. Thanks for your insight as everything on New Hampshire and Dr. Carson's prospect of running for president. Howie Carr will be back with us very soon here on America's Forum, as will we after this commercial break.